In Land O'Lakes, Florida last week, Mikey Spruill took his parents' car out without permission. Dressed only in his underwear, Mikey backed out of his driveway and ran into two cars. He continued on his merry way down to the local convenience store parking lot and then out onto Interstate 41. Shortly afterwards, he crashed into motorist Warren Wise and ended his joyride. Imagine the look on Warren's face when he saw the driver. That's because Mikey is only 3 years old. No charges have been filed, but Mikey was grounded from his battery-powered truck on Saturday afternoon.
It's not just black youths killing people in Florida anymore. Last week in Wildwood, Florida, 70-year-old Grace Eberhardt was attacked and mutilated by at least four alligators. Wildlife officials say that this is the seventh alligator killing since 1982. Officials have killed four of the gators, and a fifth one is being sought. The alligator is described as being 5 foot long with green and rough skin. Anyone with information is encouraged to call the wildlife officials at area code 408-969-9807. No pun intended, but the gator is considered to be armed and dangerous. Do not approach it. Last week, when basketball star Michael Jordan announced his retirement and subsequently shocked the world, no one was really sure how his teammates were feeling. After interviewing several members of the team, the feeling is mutual among all the players. With Jordan finally out of the way, maybe someone else will finally get to shoot the ball. Here's an interesting stretch of bad luck. In Charles City, Virginia, a suspected coke dealer didn't see the light, which led to his apprehension. Deputies of Charles City chased down the suspected drug dealer by following his shoe taillights. The suspect had fled into a wooded area at night, hoping to elude the pursuing law. But unfortunately for him, he was wearing a pair of LA Gear light athletic shoes. The dealer forgot that his battery-powered footwear intended to protect nighttime joggers flashed every time one of his feet hit the ground.
In the latest Harbinger, that outrageously awesome ICC newspaper, there was a report that a male student was arrested for grabbing a female student's left breast. East Peoria police arrested the male and took him away. Apparently, had the male student grabbed her right breast instead, he could have gotten what was behind door number two, which was a dinner with the female and a lifetime supply of Snapple. With the claims recent release of Mortal Kombat, parents and some organizations have been protesting the violence it portrays. Brutal deaths of a player's opponent if they win. Unfortunately for Acclaim, last week, 7-year-old Jimmy Rogers was arrested after he played Mortal Kombat and then proceeded to walk up to his 3-year-old sister, Jane, and rip out her heart while it was still beating, sewed it to her before she died. Police say Jimmy was led away repeating finisher and fatality 100,000 points. And finally, just when he thought it was safe to go back to the record store, Weird Al Yankovic just released his latest album. The album entitled Owlapalooza features some of Al's best work to date. Some of those parodies include Living in the Fridge, a spoof of Aerosmith's Living on the Edge, Achy Breaky song from that now country nobody, Billy Ray, Oh Well, That's Hollywood for You, and his largest production of Jurassic Park, a rip off of Jimmy Webb's classic MacArthur Park.
Thank you for watching the channel 86 News at noon. Tomorrow at noon, be sure to join us as Josh Evans, the brain behind the station, interviews Jesus Christ and attempts to argue the validity of the Bible. That's right, folks. Jesus Christ is going to be here for his first interview in almost 2,000 years. I'm Bob Davis.
And I'm Chad Lawrence.
Have a pleasant afternoon.